hand in another time. Oh! And I said, what?
He was an hour late. He should get a fired slip.
Just because the weather was so terrible. So, I said, you got to get it. So we've been driving for 2 hours. We landed like a long wizard. But there was no way that we weren't showing up tonight. That I put it this way, the drive was about 3 times longer than the flight. But we made it, that's all that matters, right? And I'm here today for one main reason. To thank you, the people of North Carolina. You went out and pounded the pavement, you organized your fellow citizens, and propelled to victory a grassroots movement the likes of which nobody has ever seen before. And that's beyond our comprehension. And I want to give a special thank you to the incredible military family, service I won't talk about it. We don't talk about numbers. We bring people together, but boy, were those numbers good. And our veterans, do we love our veterans? Your state's legacy is an inspiration to us all. North Carolina has produced many of the finest soldiers, airmen, sailors, and Marines the world has ever seen. The absolute best of us. We must follow their example, working in unison toward a shared goal across every social, racial, and economic line. They understand that to accomplish the mission, we must all be pulling in the same direction. We have to get together. They know that we must leave no man or woman behind. These patriots have shed their blood to defend our country in distant fields of battle across the earth. Our debt to them is eternal and everlasting. Sacrifice, and we salute the flag they fought to protect. We love our flag, right? We love our flag. And we don't like it when we see people ripping up our flag and burning our flag. We don't like it. And we'll see what we're going to do about that. It's a milestone that marks the ultimate sacrifice of those who wear the great uniform. It's a reminder, too, of the valiant efforts of America's fighting men and women who have liberated millions from tyranny and oppression. Now, today, our brave men and women are the first in line defense, against radical Islamic terrorism, words that some people don't like to say, an ideology of death that slaughters innocent men, women, and children. We're going to protect our people. We're going to protect our country. And every generation, a new threat to freedom arises. And just as we defeated these threats, we face generations of the past, and you understand that. So too will we defeat the forces of terrorism. It's unseen in many cases, but we're going to defeat that force. And we're going to defeat it strongly and quickly. Yeah. We will prevail. We stand here today, just miles from Fort Bragg, have been the tip of the spear in fighting terrorism. The motto of our Army Special Forces is to free the oppressed. And that is exactly what they have been doing and will continue to do. At this very moment, soldiers from Fort Bragg are deployed in 90 countries around the world. Can you believe me? 90 countries. Based in Fort Bragg is the 82nd Airborne Division. The All-American Division. We stand in awe of their achievements. Not far from here ships 45% of the entire United States Marine Corps at Camp North Carolina Army and Air National Guard. The National Guard rushed to the scene to help the victims of Hurricane Matthew and so many other catastrophes. And we continue to send our thoughts and prayers to those recovering in this way. The military families in North Carolina are a national treasure, and it will be the duty of my administration to ensure that we protect those who protect us.
Hey, Rays.
I just want to thank you that we are going to be taking care of our veterans. And they haven't been treated fairly. And I'm right now working on picking the people that are going to be helping our veterans, and they are really outstanding. We have some of the great people, a lot of people that are giving, making great sacrifices to do this. But they're going to be unbelievable. You're going to see such a change. You're going to see such a change like you've never seen before. We're going to protect and help our veterans. That brings me to the second reason to discuss our action plan to make America great again. We will. You're going to see it. I'm so looking forward, probably next week. You're going to see what we're going to do to take care of our vets. It's going to be announced. A lot of things are going to be announced. Stay tuned. Here are the priorities that will guide our military and veterans policy. All men and women in uniform will have the supplies, support, equipment, training, services, medical care, and resources to get the job done incredibly well. And best care in the world for our veterans, both at public and VA facilities, as well as the right to see a private doctor when the line is open. I've been saying this for the last year and a half. Now, people are waiting in line for 7 days, 8 days, 9 days, longer. You just said longer than that. And when that happens, you're going out to see a private doctor, a private hospital, a public hospital, somebody that can take care of you, and we're going to pick up the bill. And it's going to be, not only is it going to be great for you and life-saving in many cases, it's going to be less expensive. And I'm saying, why can they do this in the past? Why can somebody do this? There's not going to be any more waiting for our great people in line for weeks to see a doctor. Finally, a commitment to only engage the use of military forces when it's in the vital national security interests of the United States. We don't want to have a depleted military because we're all over the place fighting in areas. We're going to have have such a strong, powerful military. It's not going to be depleted any longer. I mentioned equipment previously, and I said, equipment. We're going to have the finest equipment in the world. It's going to be new. It's going to be modern. It's going to be clean. It's going to be the best. That's what we're going to have. We're not going to be a depleted military anymore. Foreign regimes that we know nothing about.
That's right.
That we shouldn't be involved with. Instead, our focus must be on defeating terrorism and destroying ISIS. Any nation that shares these goals will be our partner in this mission. We won't forget. We want to strengthen old friendships and seek out new friendships. Rather than a rigid dogma, we're guided by the lessons of history and a desire to promote stability all over, and strength in our land. This destructive cycle of intervention and chaos must finally, folks, come to an end. We've spent, at last count, $6 trillion in the Middle East. And our roads have potholes all over. Our highways are falling apart. Our bridges are falling.
Preach!
Our tunnels are no good. Our airports are horrible, like third world countries. We gotta start spending on ourselves. But we've gotta be so strong militarily, like we've never, ever been before. Remember that. And we believe that respect for mutual sovereignty helps form the basis of trust and understanding. But we don't want people taking advantage of us anymore. We don't want countries taking advantage of us anymore. We don't want that. We want to be smart people. We don't want to be what we've been over the last long period of time. We build up our military not as an act of aggression, but as an act of prevention. We pursue and build up arms not in order to seek conflict, but in order to avoid conflict. We want to be strong. In short, we seek peace through strength. Congress, I am going to ask for the elimination of the defense sequester. Depletion, I call it depletion. It's worse and worse every year, not for our military. We will show the world that America is going to be strong again, stronger than ever before. We're going to be stronger militarily than ever before. And hopefully we don't have to use our military. But we're going to be stronger than ever before, and there's rarely been a time when we've needed this strength more than we have right now. But in order to succeed with our defense policy, we must find the right person to lead our defense department. Is that right? General James Operation Desert Strong, and you saw when that happened. What happened? That was the way you're supposed to lead it. There was no games. Bad dog plays no games, right? Let the forces that went after the dog and commanded the 1st Marine Division in Iraq. He is one of the most effective generals that we've had in many, many decades. An extraordinary leader of our time who has committed his life to his love for our country. General Mattis is the living embodiment of the Marine Corps motto, Semper Fidelis, always faithful. And the American people are fortunate that a man of this character and integrity will now be the civilian leader atop the Department of Defense. Under his leadership. We will rebuild our military and alliances, destroy terrorists, face our enemies head on, and make America safe again. It is now my honor and privilege to welcome to the stage your next Secretary of Defense.
Points.
And we went down and we won Florida. Remember that fantastic evening? We have breaking news. Donald Trump wins Florida.